So CLT stands for cross-laminated timber. CLT itself is utilizing dimensional lumber to create larger elements. We've been doing that for years in the United States with glue-laminated beams and columns, and now that same technology is being applied to large floor plates and wall plates. They go through a process at the factory so that they are a complete prefabricated element that requires no work on the job sites. Put them on a truck, drive them to the job site, and then they just go in. My name is Mark Bartlett, Regional Director for Woodworks, a licensed professional engineer in the state of Texas. Cross-laminated timber has a great strength-to-weight ratio, all wood does. It allows us to get CLT panels that can span large distances but not add substantial weight to the overall building. In high seismic areas, that means less seismic forces on the foundations. In a less seismic area, like Texas, the foundations for the building don't need to be as extensive or as expensive. The latest version of the International Building Code, the 2021 version, has allowed mass timber construction to go up to 18 stories tall. To get 18 stories approved, CLT had to go through an extensive testing criteria. We've tested it in fire applications, seismic applications, we've done testing for blast resistance, and we've also done testing for what's called a missile impact test for tornado shelters. It certainly wouldn't have been approved for 18 stories if it hadn't passed the test with flying colors. Obviously, fire-related concerns have been one of the most important things that we've researched. Wood is a combustible material. What we have to understand, though, is that it doesn't mean that it's going to continue to burn once a char layer is formed on the large elements. That will insulate the interior of the wood, keep it at a reasonable temperature, keep its load-carrying capacity sufficient, and then that char layer is harder to burn. That's why CLT works, is that when it does catch fire, it doesn't sustain combustibility. Even though there's glue involved in the manufacturing, the glues all have to pass these elevated temperature tests to prove that they can survive a fire. As of 4 years ago, there were zero CLT projects in Texas, and now we have several that have already been completed and several dozen that are in design right now in various cities across the state, including the building that we're in right here, the First United Bank in Fredericksburg. I think for CLT to really have a bright future, we need to have more localized manufacturing of the material. Right now, one of the big things that we deal with is transportation costs and obviously the fuel that's used in moving that material around. And local manufacturing can eliminate those costs and eliminate that impact on our environment. Texas is not shrinking. We got more people moving here every day. We need more construction, and I think we need to look at that construction in a sustainable manner. And I think with the amount of trees that we have available to us, that a CLT plant would make tremendous sense in Texas.